you don't know who I am, my name's Christian. And last summer of 2023, I felt like I had it all. I was working a sales job. I was making money like online, remotely. Me and my family, we went on this beautiful vacation to Australia. We went to Sydney and Melbourne and life just felt amazing. And then towards the end of summer, around August, I decided to quit that sales job and pursue this YouTube channel. And a whole bunch of procrastination and self-sabotage later, we're here. It's been a good 9-10 months since I posted my first video, and I haven't really been like living up to what I know I should be doing. I haven't been posting that consistently. I haven't really been giving my all into it. And in this time since I've started my channel, since August, I've literally only gained like 100 subscribers, and I'm super grateful for that. Like, that's 100 new subscribers I didn't have, but I know I could be doing better. I know my potential. So it's time to get my life back together. It's time to stop procrastinating and stop doing the bad habits and sabotaging my own personal growth. So that's why I made this series, Getting My Life Back Together. Today is day zero, or the preparation day, where I get everything ready to kick off this new season of my life. So today I woke up a little late, and that's because I stayed up late doing a certain bad habit, and you can kind of do with that what you will. But pretty much all this is gonna stop because this is the season of my life where I'm really gonna lock the fuck in. Like, where I'm really just gonna like take life by the balls, because I haven't been. I've been slacking, I know that. So yeah, I'm starting off with making my bed, and I'm gonna go through my morning routine and kind of explain it to you, tell you why I do everything. And make my bed just cause, you know, like, it's, who wants to come back home to a messy bed, bro? You gotta do it. And now I'm doing this certain habit, and you might not have heard of it. It's called gratitude journaling. And pretty much I literally just take my journal and I write down a couple things I'm grateful for every morning. And I find this habit, it's helped me so much, like with my mental health, because you're just like acknowledging the things that you're grateful for. And just as I was going through my morning routine, my mom actually told me, hey, drop Dom down to the bus stop, because my mom usually drops him down and he's actually supposed to walk, but you know, he's usually a little late. So I dropped him down. All right. So once I got back in the house, I made my like electrolyte type of drink pretty much. And this is pretty important to do in the morning, because overnight, obviously, you're not drinking water, so you're not hydrated. So what I do for this drink is I just take a little cup of water, and it's a little bit of salt for the sodium, because that's like the main thing that you sweat out. So sodium, and then I think it's magnesium in the lemon, whatever, I don't know. Someone just told me to put lemon in there. And then grab a bit of coconut water, and that's the last ingredient. That's high in potassium. So you're getting all the big three. You're getting sodium, magnesium, potassium. This is amazing to get in the morning. It really like rehydrates you. And then I actually pair this habit with like getting morning sunlight, and this is a pretty like interesting habit as well. It's if you know Dr. Huberman, you know this habit. Pretty much viewing the sunlight in the morning, it's something like natural, something like our ancestors would have done. They would have woken up, they would have gotten out their caves and seen the sunlight. And what this does is it sets your like circadian rhythm, it sets your clock for the day pretty much. And it also kind of sets the release of melatonin, which is like your natural sleep hormone, I guess it is, for around 16 to 18 hours after you viewed the sunlight, so that you naturally feel tired at the time that you should be going to bed, you know. And then after that, I went in the shower, and if you're expecting any shower footage, come on, bro. I don't know, maybe if we hit like 1k subs, do a bit of shower footage for you guys. But and then after that, I did some meditation. If you're on self-improvement, if you know about this, then this is a standard. But if you've never meditated before, you know what? Let's do it right now. Close your eyes. I said close your eyes. Come on. Close your eyes. Then I want you to breathe in. I want you to focus on the breath all throughout your chest and your belly, and breathe deep into your belly. And then breathe out through your nose, nice and slow. And then keep focusing on this breath. You probably have a couple of thoughts popping into your head right now, but what I want you to do is just refocus your attention back onto the breath. If you get in those thoughts, refocus. And that's meditation. Pretty much what you're trying to do with meditation is focus on your breath. And then every time you have like a thought in your head, first of all, you need to identify that thought is there. Because sometimes you'll just have thoughts randomly and you won't even realize that you're lost in thought. So this first step is identify. And then the second step, once you realize you're not focusing on the breath and that your attention is wavered, now I want you to refocus your attention back onto the breath. And this is like doing like a push-up like for your brain. And the more that you do these like mental push-ups, the more like control you're gonna have over just that little like lizard brain, that little subconscious part of your mind, because you'll actually be able to sort of hear your thoughts going on and be less so enveloped in thoughts and being, oh, gone to the next thing, on the next thing. Just be able to actually like focus yourself. And it truly is so amazing when you just get in that deep like state of focus. You have no thoughts in your brain. You're just focusing on your breath and listening to like the sounds around you. It really gives you such an appreciation of life. Just the fact that you're present. And I would do this outside too if you could. Just listen to the birds chirping. Listen to the leaves rustling. It's amazing, bro. I could talk about it forever. But if you're new to meditation, I would say start with just 3 minutes only. Literally just 3 minutes. And download this app called Medito. I'll probably put something up on the screen right now. And just do the 3 minute guided meditation every single morning. And I swear to you, you might not feel it on the first week, you might not feel it on the second week, but if you keep doing this, you will just have this new like calmness and control over your mind that you didn't have before. All right, now it's time for work. And I don't really have any other videos that I'm working on or any editing to do. I guess my only work task really is to record this video. So what I did is I also used this time to kind of formulate the whole like dopamine detox and monk mode protocol, pretty much like what type of things I'd be doing for this like season, this period of locking like the fuck in and really getting my life back together, you know. So I watched the woke snake himself, the most woke YouTuber on the planet. I probably sound like an idiot if you don't know this guy, but it's Alex Becker, and he's like a multi-millionaire, and he's a funny guy as well. But he has a lot of like old videos from like 3 or 4 years ago with a lot of gems about like dopamine detoxing and addictions. So I watched some of those, and to be honest, it didn't really help because I kind of knew what type of stuff I needed to do on a dopamine detox. If you don't know what that is, that's when you like get rid of all of these like easy, like quick dopamines pretty much. And for me, these things are stuff like social media and watching too much YouTube and porn and all these bad habits. So I kind of knew what I needed to give up. I just didn't really, like, I felt like, oh, I need to watch a video to do it. And this is one of the lessons from this video, that like the answer isn't going to be in some podcast or in some YouTube video or in a book. The answer is going to be in your own brain. So just sit down, let yourself think, let your brain work, and you'll find the answer. And this is like the whole point of why I'm doing this series. First, to like document my life and show you guys what I'm doing. But most importantly, to share with you like the things I do bad, the things I do good, and then like the takeaways I get from that, you know, like the lessons that I learn. Because if you're kind of similar to me, maybe the stuff that I learn will help you, and maybe, okay, you can go in the comments and say some things that'll help me with the things that I'm not doing very well, you know? So yeah, now I'm getting ready, getting my lunch ready for school. And if you wonder how I have so much time in the mornings, it's because I actually go to school later. I go to school for around like 10:15. This is because I set up my first two periods of the day as what do you call it, like dual enrollment periods, where like, I don't know, have a look if you can do this in your high school, if you're in high school. But pretty much what it is that you can take college classes while you're in high school. And then these college classes, it counts as actual periods in your day if you do them for like your core classes. So for example, I'm doing English and history. And then pretty much I do these online on my own time, and I don't need to go into school for these first two periods. So it gives me just so much time to actually do the work that I need to do. Because if I didn't have these two periods, bro, I would not be getting like any work done throughout the day, because I'd be leaving so early, be coming back so late. All right, so I just got home from school and I didn't really record, you know, I'm not trying to bring a camera to school. And now I'm eating, it looks a little nasty, and I promise it actually tastes good. It's like milk with protein powder mixed in, vanilla protein powder. It didn't really mix well, so I kind of had to like spoon a bit of it off, but you know, just getting my protein in. And now I looked at my assignments for my English class and I'm like, oh crap, I have like a 5-page essay to do. And it's already late, so I'm already gonna have late points taken off. Yeah, I tried to get do work on that. If you see me moving my lips, it's because I was trying to talk to speech it, but it just wasn't really working. And I don't know, if you don't know about me, like, I hate school, bro. I just don't see the point of it anymore. I used to be such a like a straight A student. Like, I would do so good on my tests and stuff, but I just don't like see the point of doing school anymore. I do it just to please my parents only. That's it. Because
like, I know I'm not gonna work a normal job. I'm not trying to, like, go to work and do the same task every day and take orders from a boss. I'm sorry if this offends, like, some people, but I just want to live life on my own terms. And I would rather be broke and working for myself than be rich and be, like, working for a boss and answering to someone else. So, I don't know, maybe that's just the way I am. I just came back from kickboxing and I forgot to record because I'm an idiot, but anyways, I really like kickboxing just because it's like, it's different from the gym. It's not just the, oh, lifting weights. Like, you get that cardio aspect, so you actually, like, kind of feel fit. And I feel like it's really helped my confidence as well. Because, like, okay, like, you don't want to be violent, obviously, but just knowing that you have the ability in case something happens to protect yourself and to protect your loved ones, that kind of makes you, like, a lot more confident, you know? Like, I think the quote goes, like, it's better to be a warrior in a garden than a garden in a war. And, like, I'm not telling you to go out and start fighting people, but just learn how to fight. Learn how to defend yourself so that in case anything happens, you feel confident, you feel secure. Because now I can walk around knowing that, like, I can defend myself, and it just makes me feel confident, you know? I'm not a pro. I've only been doing it for 9 months, but definitely something you should try if you haven't tried a martial art. Try kickboxing, try boxing. Try MMA, whatever you want, bro. Alright, so I went in the shower, I grabbed some dinner, and I'll be honest, it doesn't look the most appetizing, but it does taste pretty good. And then I wrote down and hung up these papers on my wall for this challenge, for the season of my life. And it might seem kind of weird, like, oh, why the hell am I putting sticking pieces of tape and paper to my wall? But, like, when I wake up and get out of bed and see, like, my habit tracker, see my dopamine detox protocol, and see these reminders of this, like, period, the season of my life, it's gonna make me so much more consistent. So all I did is put up one paper with, like, the amount of time I have remaining, you know, just like, oh, hyping me up, 8 weeks remaining. And then I did a paper for the dopamine detox that I'm doing, you know, just like getting rid of all these, like, cheap, easy dopamines, these instant gratification activities. So for me, I put down, like, no social media, and I'll download, like, Instagram, whatever, only if I'm, like, posting a story on it. And then educational YouTube only. And I put this because YouTube really can be a tool only if you use it for education, because for entertainment, you're just wasting your time. And of course, it's nice to, like, watch some YouTube videos while you're eating and stuff, but I don't have time for entertainment at this period of my life. I really just need to, like, lock in and do the work. So I put only educational YouTube, and I put no video games. And this might hit home for, like, some of you guys, but for me, I really didn't even need to put this down because I just don't play video games. It's not something I do anymore. And then at the bottom, I put 2 hours a day of max screen time. And, you know, like, I'm just trying to spend less time on my phone. And then I even went as far as, like, limiting dopamine from music and from sweet treats too. Like, I put 1 day a week each of music and of like, added sugar. Because believe it or not, both of these things give you a lot of dopamine, and they can be seen as instant gratification activities. I don't know if I've explained this before, but the difference between instant delayed gratification. Instant, it's like the things that feel good now in the moment, but the things that make your life worse in the future. So something like eating McDonald's or eating a sweet treat, because it feels good now, it tastes good, but then it makes you fatter, and it makes you more unhealthy. And then also music as well. Like, so many people live their entire lives with, like, AirPods and just listening to someone else talking about their own life achievements. And I used to be the same thing. I used to just be in class 24/7, just have AirPods in. And, like, then I got to the point where I couldn't even, like, be in, like, normal situations without listening to music. I couldn't do the dishes without putting a song on. I couldn't be in class without putting a song on. I couldn't do my work without putting a song on. And I'm not at this point now, but I'm really just trying to get rid of all of these, like, easy sources of dopamine that I used to rely on, that I still kind of rely on heavily. And then obviously, you know, no porn for this too, but I'm not trying to put that on my wall so, like, people see it when they come in my room. And the next paper I have is my habit tracker. And this is so important. There was a period of my life around, like, end of July and August of 2023 where I was so productive. It's when I was still on the back end of trying to do that, like, marketing agency and working that sales job, and when I was just starting to upload my new videos. So I was split between these two things, and I still managed my time and got a whole bunch of work done because of this habit tracker. And it might sound kind of stupid, like, what, it's just a habit tracker, it's just logging your habits. But the fact that you see it and the fact that you log it every day, it keeps you consistent, because your brain, it isn't like a Notion, it isn't a notes app, it doesn't
remember these things, but having like a physical reminder of the things you need to accomplish, like it helps you stay consistent, and consistency is key. So my like non-negotiable habits, if you want to call it that, like the ones that I'm not missing every day, every week, it's 10 minutes a day of meditation. And this is like self-explanatory. We've already talked about meditation. It's amazing. 30 minutes a day of exercise. Again, like bro, 30 minutes a day at the least. This should be the bare minimum of exercise. And I know I might miss some days, that's fine, but bro, exercise is like the cornerstone of self-improvement. You probably are watching me because a couple months ago, because a year ago, you went to the gym. And that habit of going to the gym, it propelled you down the cycle of, okay, gym, and then maybe trying to get girls, and then getting girls, and then entrepreneurship, and business, and money, and self-improvement, you know? So exercise is a cornerstone habit, and you can't forget about it, because although it's what got you into this journey, because it's what got me into this journey, like, I've kind of been neglecting it and forgetting about it. I've been skipping workouts and not being consistent, and I can't do this. I can't let my physique and my health slip. The third one I have is 60 minutes a day of YouTube work, so like working on this channel, and that's I'm gonna be doing at least 60 minutes every single day to try and like do these daily uploads. So I'm not too worried about that. Next one, 5 pages a day of an educational book. And this is such like an important habit for me, because learning is the cornerstone of self-improvement. If you're not learning, you're not earning. Didn't mean to fucking rhyme that. If you're not learning, you're just not like improving yourself. It's like in anything, bro. If you're not learning about better nutrition and better eating habits, you're just gonna stagnate. If you're not learning how to train better, your physique's gonna stagnate. If you're not learning more things about business, your business is gonna stagnate. You always need to be learning. The last one is doing 2 cold approaches every single week. And if you don't know what that is, if you haven't heard that term before, it's literally just going up to a girl that you don't know, approaching her, and then like, you know, having a conversation, asking for a number, whatever. And this sounds simple, like, oh, it's just going up and talking to a girl, but like, it's not easy, bro, because you're gonna see like a cute girl and your brain's gonna spaz out like, oh, well, she has a boyfriend, she's busy, whatever. And this happens to me too. So I'm trying to get over this hurdle of not being able to like speak to girls I see that are attractive, because like me, like, I've made leaps and bounds in my social skills. I can talk to pretty much anyone. I can talk to old people, young people, people my age, whatever, except for girls I find attractive. So I'm just trying to change that. I'm trying to fix that. And I'm trying to make it that, like, if I'm just going about life and I see an attractive girl, I can just go up and strike a conversation with her, like, easily. So this has been day 0 of getting my life back together. And I'm so fucking excited to, like, start this new chapter of my life and to really lock in for the first time in, like, years, I would say. And I'm even more excited to document this journey with you guys. So if you want to stick along for the ride, if you want to see my progression and follow along and grow with me, then please scroll down and press subscribe. I'm going to be posting videos every single day at 6 p.m. Eastern time. And I want you to be on this journey with me. I want you to improve with me. So that's it, bro. And as always, I'm rooting for you.